Hello, anatomy colleagues. This is Dr. Alsip, and we are going to be talking about two nerves that are going to be innervating two of the muscles of mastication. So these are going to be the more superficial muscles of mastication, and it'll be easier to see these nerves in this region. So both of these branches, both the masseteric nerve as well as the deep temporal nerves, will both be branches of the anterior trunk of V3, or the mandibular nerve. So we can see them a little bit easier in different regions. That's why we have two separate pictures here. So let's start with the masseteric nerve. As you probably would guess, it is going to innervate the masseter muscle. So right here you can see the masseteric nerve and the artery. They are traveling over the mandibular notch between the coronoid process and the condylar process. And these are heading to innervate or supply the deep surface of the masseter muscle, which the masseter muscle in this particular dissection has been reflected. But it is this masseteric nerve that will supply or innervate this muscle. The deep temporal nerves are small, and I mean very small, branches of V3 anterior division that are going to be variable both in how many branches there are as well as how they distribute. You can see one pretty nicely right here close to the posterior deep temporal artery, and it is heading towards the deep surface of the temporalis muscle that has been reflected in this particular dissection. So this right here is one of the deep temporal nerves. As I mentioned, there can be multiple branches of the deep temporal nerves just kind of heading to the expanse of the temporalis muscle. But the point is that this is going to be a branch of V3 because all the muscles of mastication are innervated by V3. And so that's it. Those are the two nerves that we have to know for this particular session. We will get into V3 and all of its branches when we get to the infratemporal fossa. So we'll spend quite a bit more time there, but we did want to introduce the ones that you could see in a more superficial dissection in this particular video. So take time to review. If you have any questions, please always feel free to reach out to me or any of my anatomy colleagues, and have a great rest of your day.